This weekend, the latest Hunger Games film, Mockingjay Part 1, hit theaters. Our Matt Perrin has the review in our Monday Movie Musings.
Welcome to another Monday. This is one of those weeks that I had absolutely no doubt what I was going to review, but especially after it had the biggest opening weekend of the year. I was told I need to hurry this one up, so with no further ado, here's my take on the Hunger Games Part 3, Part 1. Yeah, that's right, Mockingjay Part 1. Our movie begins pretty much where the last one left off. Katniss, BT, and Finnick have been rescued from the game arena and are recuperating. We see that Katniss is dealing with a bout of PTSD, made a little worse with PETA being left behind to be captured by the Capitol. We are introduced to the president of the rebellion, President Cohen, played by Julianne Moore. She wants Katniss to become the Mockingjay, which is the symbol of the rebellion. At first refusing, Katniss is forced to bear witness to what the Capitol did by laying waste to her old district. Agreeing to be the face of the rebellion, Katniss proceeds to take part in a series of propaganda films to cause an uprising in the districts and bring more allies to the rebellion. Meanwhile, President Snow in the Capitol is using PETA to make his own propaganda films, hoping to squash the rebellion. With the Capitol becoming more violent towards the districts, it doesn't take long for the civilians to jump on board and start fighting back. As the film progresses, we see Katniss deal with the struggle of being the symbol for war, and we see the ever-increasing importance to free the captured tributes from their imprisonment. The action continues to build, and of course, being divided into a two-part movie, we are left on the edge of our seats, eagerly anticipating the conclusion next year. This series is one of those few book-to-movie adaptations that I haven't actually read the series, so I'm in no position to tell you whether the movie does the book any justice. What I can tell you is that it pretty much was exactly what I expected. Ever since Harry Potter started the trend of making a longer book into two movies, you can pretty much bank on the fact that the first of the two will have a little bit of action, but mainly serve as setting a platform for the conclusion. It drags at times, but I'm sure that the dragging will end up being imperative to next year's film. What I found hard watching the movie is that since the passing of Philip Seymour Hoffman, they had to digitally enter him in some of the films. And you can tell those parts because you're looking at him talking, but his voice just doesn't sound quite right. Anyway, I'm definitely looking forward to next fall / winter when the conclusion comes out. This has been your Monday Movie Musing. Back to you.
All right, Matt, thank you. Still to come, a final check of the forecast with meteorologist Jonathan Kennedy. Stay with us.